Hello, my dear friends. Today I wanted to talk to you about all the backgrounds in the canon. When you click new character, you can make custom. We'll slowly go over there. So no significance is nothing. It gives you nothing. It removes nothing. Boring. Okay. Here's the very cool dark side. So it basically swap daytime and nighttime. What is good about this is that your prowling detection is still good at night, and now at night your lockpick is better when it's dark, because normally lockpicking is better when it's light. Other than that, it's rather, you know, rather funky, not useful. Oh, miracle operation, here we are. If you wanna have a skin drop to zero, it's possible with this shit. This is zero background, but it's so fucking wide, some specific build can really benefit from it. It's like, you get like minus fucking 11 and plus fucking 11. It's crazy. And it also give you perception, which make it bad automatically, unless you have gun build. And even if you have gun build, so much perception energy is useless. Hey, Mad Doctor, another... This is minus, right? Yeah, it's minus background. It gives you fucking plus 4, which is perception there. And remove you fucking 7. Thank you. Oh, Frankenstein Monster, okay. So this is very good background. It's okay for fucking male, but female version is more interesting. Bride of Frankenstein, because it remove you less, it remove only dexterity, but it give beauty and constitution instead of, you know, it's very solid. It only give you weakness to fire. Electrical resistance is here, like, very significant. It can help you make beautiful character. Giant downside is that you are dumb. No matter how much intelligence you have, you are dumb. So you cannot use books for crafting, and you cannot really craft well without like throwing a lot of points into crafting. Okay, only child. This is like willpower, right? Okay, so this is very good background. You'd never need persuasion on or haggle 20 out of 20, excluding final boss. And maybe I forgot if you need 20 out of... Oh yeah, you need 20 out of 20 for master persuasion. Other than that, it's perfect background. It's plus 2 background. Charisma is useless. Plus willpower is great. Let's go Technophobe. Technophobe is tragic because you cannot pick up any technological items. And this include ore, this includes some mission items. Anything that can be used for crafting, any trap, it's terrible. It's not completely debilitating, but very close. Ah, you have bandit minus charisma. But start with gun. And don't have any cash, so this is terrible. Oh, you have some bonus to firearm skill. This is probably plus 1. It's useless. Okay, arsonist would be fun, but it gives you explosive for minus con, so it's minus background. Magic allergy. Okay, so you cannot use any magical items, but you can use spells. This is quite stupid, this magical energy. It's garbo background, because some of magical items are still useful for you. Afraid of dark. Yeah, bonus perception for fucking penalties. In darkness. It's absolutely useless. Hydrophobic. So hydrophobic have very red downside, but it's still downside. And you gain bonus to persuasion. Trash. Agoraphobic, another trash background. Nature Mage. Okay, Nature Mage is... Natural Surfer. Man-made Surfer. I wonder what cave qualifies us. This doesn't specify what the fuck is cave, for example. If entrance of the cave is some underground fucking dungeons. Because you mostly of the time fight in like very close, in close proximity to grass or other places, unless you fight indoors. But let's just say this is dungeon in dwarven fucking tunnels. It's technically man-made by definition, but it's still natural surface if it does just fucking ground. It's very like hard because this doesn't specify. So you need to fucking play this at least once, entire fucking game, to know exactly how it apply. I never played this because it didn't work. But it could be useful. It's fun. Wait, what? Okay. Sky Mage, it's same shit but worse. Outdoors, indoors, kind of easy to understand at least. Night Mage is great. Because it's 6 to 6, so 12 hours this, 12 hours that. And what is very good about this, at the day you can play as technologist and at night you can become mage. It's not very useful, but it's gimmicky. So if you wanna have always like 20 technical aptitude and 40 magical aptitude at the same time, this is for you. It will give you 40 into 40 in other direction, I think. Yeah, there is damage, it's reverse, it's worse. Damage is worse, well, both are trash, by the way. But Night Mage at least can buy from Techno Shop. And then go into the other direction. Soul to Your Souls is very good if you wanna explore evil route in the game. Especially if you don't exactly... if you cannot fucking fall for evil. It gives you magical aptitude, which is worthless. It gives you minus reaction and alignment. It's okay, it's just... it's not nice. People don't like you immediately and bonus is not substantial enough to justify it. Poster chill. Bonus experience is mech. It gives you critical failures more often, which is annoying as fuck. And only critical failures, it doesn't give you critical successes. I don't recommend it's minus, even if it's zero. And here we are with Barbarian, plus 3, minus 3. With bonus to melee, suffer penalties to Hagu. And also are more or less monades, Garbo. It's like technically plus because melee is better than Hagu. And both are useless. I mean, Hagu expert you can get with drink, if you go magical character, it's plus technically, but it's not plus. Tomboy is nice, it reverts you from female to like male. It's garbage because constitution is much better than strength. But it's a choice. Idiot Savant, here we fucking are. It makes you smart but lock you to dumb dialogue, which means you cannot use book. So when you use book, you take your intelligence, but when you are moron or locked to dumb dialogue, you have one intelligence on book. So you cannot craft something like Vivifier, but that require 90 chemicals, 90 fucking herbology, 90 whatever the fuck else before this. So you are basically locked from best item in the game, and you are locked to dumb dialogue, and you get bonus to intelligence, which is craft exclusive, with no bonuses to crafting. It's fucking painful. Escape Lunatic is the best background in the game. Give you resistance to everything. and make people like you less. Absolute perfection. It's basically give you armor, make you tanky. It's perfect. It has no downside other than reaction. Reaction can be gained by apologizing to people and being polite. So I would say absolute plus. Super model. No, yeah, you are beautiful, but very like dumb and fucking weak. It's trash. Beauty has no real upside. Don't recommend. Okay, Educator is trash. If you have installed UAP, there is option to give you Educator automatically, which kind of make this background useless. It basically let followers mimic your training if you receive it. It's but give you one less follower. I don't know how to like describe it since. Since now your followers can just automatically train with you up. Charlatan Prodigy is great, it's plus 2. Charisma is like, you know, this bad stat technically. Bad stat plus. Strength and Constitution are both good stats. So it's hard to justify, but Charlatan Prodigy is great. Because Charisma, outside of being bad stat, is also good stat. Because it lets you get more followers, and having 14 means you can basically have an army early. And this lets you get 20 charisma without spending single point in charisma. It's extremely good in that case. It's plus 2 background clearly. You eventually wanna end with something like 20 willpower, 20 here, and 20 willpower. This like triangle of fucking 20s. On top of that, whatever is in your build. If you are intelligent technologist, you want intelligence 20 instead of willpower 20. However, I personally don't understand like appeal of technologist character. Hey, let's go forward. Raised by Orc. This is useful on characters who are repulsive. Like for example, if your race have a natural less charisma, you can use the bonus perception is naturally useless, it's minus 2 background, which is trash. Debutant is great, it's plus fucking 4 background. It's first plus 4 background, and I think it's give you minus 2 to all fucking combat skills. Which is debilitating, but not completely. You can still get to 20 out of 20, you can still get training, you can still kind of work with it. It's just fucking hard. Beauty is like bad stat, it's like better than perception, which is not achievement. And charisma is this bad stat plus, which is better than beauty, but that's not achievement. But give you companions, which is a huge upside. It's best background if you wanna have 20 everywhere, especially with half elf. Okay, let's go forward. Beat with ugly stick. This is good for some ugly races because you can overfloat one beauty and it's not great, you know. It's not great in any fucking way. Yeah, sickly is bad. Intelligence bonus don't justify fucking minus 7. Feral Child. It's terrible. It's terrible, it gives you plus 3 dexterity at 4 minus 6. For fuck's sake. Oh, Rise in Pits is great for half ogres. Because it overflow your intelligence to 1. Which means it goes plus 0 to you. So you have, you know, with half ogre, this is plus 0 background, but that gives you combat skills, which is actually plus in total. It's not great, but it also gives you some items for stats. It's not terrible for half ogre. specifically because it's harder to get armor. And run away with Cyrus. Some people like it, I don't. And that's probably all I can say about this. It's, the intelligence is eh. Perception is eh. And willpower is so getting strength for it is kind of only upside. Because you are much fucking stronger early for no downsides, literally. You don't lose anything. Willpower 5 still allow you to cast spells. Intelligence 5 still allow you to cast spells. And perception don't exist in the game. And Troll of Springs, here we are. So this is debilitating minus fucking 08, absolutely no question. A Sheltered Child, got yeah, another one of this garbo, minus fucking 1. The bonuses are to willpower, perception and intelligence, and minuses to strength, terrible, it's basically Runaway with Cyrus reverse. Army training is great, minus 1 dexterity is painful, but it's nothing, and you get the bonus skills, bow and melee. A bow melee skill bonus is great because you can on 2 points get extra melee. And bow bonus is better than nothing. It's plus 1 point, it's useless. But, so it's zero background with some upsides. It's not trash, it's just... Hyperactive is great. Okay, so hyperactive is minus 1 background. However, it increases your speed. Max speed is 100. And if you are Time Wizard, your max speed is maybe 70. So having this max speed increased to like 70 fucking 1 is great at the end. With this, your max speed is basically improved. I cannot properly state how good it is because it's very hard to... Because speed is useless at these numbers. If you get to high speed build, you don't feel it. So it's only good if you wanna go for low speed build. By low speed I mean 20 dexterity and maybe magic boots of speed. Instead of everything. So if you are not a time wizard, it might be good for you. Because at the end of the day you will get like plus one to this speed that's ultra important later. It's hard with speed, because speed increases your movement per turn. It's not exactly super useful. Weapon speed is different than character speed, so it's... Maybe it's hard to advocate it. But it's good, it's just... Whatever good. Elven blood is useless. It's actually minus technically, because... Penalty to technical skills means that if you wanna, for example, expert at anything, it will be harder for you. It's terrible for technologies and not great for mage. Also, magic aptitude is worthless, you will get it for learning spells. And wearing dark helmet. Yeah, bully is plus zero background, it's zero, it's useless. I mean, technically you get rid of useless intelligence, but intelligence 8 is a kind of not only breaking point for books, but also let you hold another spell, so it's not good enough. Okay, bookworm is technically plus 0, but it's good, because you get plus intelligence for minus perception, both are useless, so whatever. Extreme personality is roleplay, background is giving you nothing. Excluding roleplay, and reactions are stronger towards you. Because I more often cause repulsive reactions towards me, it's not useful for me. Born on their side is kind of useful, especially for critical build. Make your critical hits and critical misses more likely to get into like stronger, into more spectacular effect of both. Yeah, Charm School, it's exclusive for females, it's basically debutante but worse. The debutante exists, so I don't know why would you take it. shopkeeper, this is trash, give you haggle bonus, which is worthless. In exchange for minus one dexterity, which is terrible. Absolutely no. Knife tosser is another garbage. Okay, so this is actually interesting because throwing require you to have dexterity, not perception. So this is minus one background, but this throwing skill bonus give you plus one out of 20. It doesn't give you plus four, which is garbage. It's not good enough to justify minus one perception, that is trash. A special person, here we go. Yeah, it's minus two. Upside will not overcome minus two. What is this? Inheritance. More money. Oh fuck, it's worthless. Child of Hero. It's another garbage, right? So if you act evil, you gain more evil. If you act good, you get same good. And you start with sword. Wait, you are known as Child of Hero, that gives you a unique reputation. Wait. This Child of Hero is your fame? I don't know, it's not in fame list. So it's only downside is for reputation. Okay, it's lying to you in description. Rise by Monks is great, it's plus one. However, you will have to keep in mind. You start with like no cash, and the only plus one you get from it is fucking plus one perception. It's better to go debutante in half health. You wanna have fucking attributes for 20 everywhere. And it's better to go escape lunatic in human if you wanna have good build actually. Okay, this should take care of most garbage. Yeah, penalty to technical skills absolutely not gonna cut it. It's terrible. Even for mage. Apprentice of Blacksmith is another. No. It's minus one. Rise by Snake Handles. This is would be good if not the fact that poison resistance you get is worthless and minus one beauty is still minus one. So that way we get rid of all like human available. There are some like unique elf sheets. It might be hard to find. Popish elf. Yeah, this is worthless, this is minus one. Because you lose dexterity, which is real attribute, for fucking persuasion, that is skill. And it's you probably gain 1 out of 20 of this persuasion, you don't gain 4 persuasion. So yeah, I think that's all for elves. There is nothing like specific that is worth anything, right? There should be no Dark Elf is like raised. Dark Elf follower, yeah, there is this. It's technically good. I mean, naturally willpower is much better for mage than charisma, however both are important, I would say, especially if you like being like charismatic person. It's good for roleplay, it's plus zero, so it can kind of help you start early as mage. But there is only son that is better, only child that is better. Half elf is like best, it's... You get like plus 2 and minus 1, so it's very good right from the there. And what we have here? I think there is no special background for elves. Okay, so we need to change from female to male and start throwing races that are male exclusive. Gnome is one of the worst races in the game. It gives you bonus to willpower. There are some differentials with Gnome, this specific. Yeah, it gives you strength. It's technically plus one. But you already play as Gnome, so I would say you already lost. I don't know what to say, because I would personally not recommend anybody to play as Gnome, it's weak race. Halfing is good. Okay, so halfing is minus one race. However, it has bonus 5% critical chance. It's insane. If you wanna go for something like... Oh, there is Halfing Orphan. Yeah, pickpocket for intelligence. It's not worth it. It's still minus one at the end of the day. All this racial specific. Wait, maybe half orc, half something. Half orc, right? Yeah, they should have something useful, I hope. I forgot. Factory SKP. Yeah, it's plus one and it's plus one in strength. So it's good, minus is that you play as Half-Orc. Which can be good and bad, depends. It gives you poison resistance, which is terrible, and it's minus fucking two race. And you are also experienced best races in the game. By best I mean the most harsh. So it's kind of good for roleplay, I would say. Half Ogre is the good race here. It's like, if you have touch skin Half Ogre, you are still weaker than fucking Escape Lunatic, so there is that. You have free, you have wield, rare, and touch hide. Yeah, touch hide is the best for damage. Resistance is still worse than fucking Escape Lunatic. And I think that's all the background. At least all worth mentioning. If you want to take away anything from it, Debutante good, Army Training good, majority of this... Oh, wait. 1 second. Rising Pits make your intelligence overflow to one. It cannot go under one. So it make your race and background plus zero in total, and you also start with fucking items and some combat skills. So it technically a plus, and you can still be intelligence, you can still rise from intelligence to 20. 20, it will be fucking extreme to 20, right? Wait, where is like intelligence? Oh yeah. Yeah, your intelligence is minus 4. How the fuck do you get 20 intelligence? I think only with potion or fucking mind marvel. Yeah, there's no other way, I think. I forgot what gives you intelligence. Other than potions or drugs. Well, regardless, you can still go to like 12 intelligence or 5 intelligence and cast spells. And so it's not debilitating, but it's like hard if you wanna go half ogre mage. Other than this specific aspect, it's rather great. We should also probably find dwarves. Because they exist. Let's see if there's something useful. Planet Dwarf. Yeah, you start with Hammer. I mean, it's something, you start with Hammer, but you lose something else, I forgot what. I think some skills you may want. Yes, whatever. It's bad. Oh, ladies, man. Yeah, it's plus zero, never mind. So we didn't miss anything, at least anything of value. Yeah, I hope it's informative, or at least you had some fucking enjoyment from me rambling how every single fucking background in the game is garbage, excluding like 5. I had an idea, you can just view intro. Okay. See you and have a good day.